What? Hi, what time is it? I think it's not quite 11:11, but close enough. Maybe it is, I don't know. I can't see the clock from here. I'm in my papercrete and get up, and I got paper all over me already. You know how when you go to drill the paper and it sprays all over and gets on you? No, it's just me. Wow. Anyway, that happened this morning. It's a good way to start off. In case you thought you were going to stay clean, make you grateful you put on your dirty clothes. As usual, I'm here to do a quick body check, let go of some stress, do a little stretching and a little strengthening, perhaps sing a little of my life to you. Still silly. Silly check. Silly check. Let's check on the spine. Let's check on the alignment first. I'm going to just root myself into the earth, bringing my attention to the bottoms of my feet. Try not to be distracted by the Superman curl. Do a little shoulder shrugging. Bring those ears over the shoulders. Jiggle those shoulders out. Bring the shoulders over the hips. Jiggle those hips out. Bring those hips over the ankles. Maybe jiggle those ankles out a little bit. Just do a little shaking it off. And then I'm gonna root myself back into the earth, bringing my attention into the bottoms of my feet. And pull up the britches, and then bending, not from the waist, so you put your hands on your hips, that's your waist. Put your hands where your legs come in, that's your hips. I'm going to forward fold from those hips, making sure not to lock the knees with a relatively flat back. Down toward the floor, bending the knees if need be to get the hands on the floor. And then relaxing the belly, relaxing the back. Just exploring that forward fold, letting gravity do some unwinding. Trying to resist the temptation of knocking all that paper off my shoes in the Head Hutt. Already did some of that. Giving that a breath or two to unwind. Let's roll back up. Pushing from the bottoms of the feet through the tailbone. One vertebrae at a time. Coming up. Let's do some shoulder rolls. Forward and then backward. Across the body. Just get a nice stretch. Oh, letting that go. I've been cleaning because this place is dirty. If you know me, you already knew that's true, but I'm just saying, I'm having a good time cleaning, but it's making my arms hurt. Give those another stretch. Just getting the flow going in those arms. Releasing tension, reducing stagnation. Letting go of stress. Sometimes I like to give them a little petting to remember to flow. Let's bring arms behind the back, clasping hands, pointing fingers, and then I'm gonna roll the shoulders toward each other. Roll elbows towards each other. Pulling those fingers down, pushing the hips forward. Just enjoying a nice counter stretch. And then I'm gonna keep in my focus on the bottoms of those feet, making sure not to lock those knees. And again, bending forward from the hips, this time with those arms coming with me. Well, they came with me last time, but this time behind me. I'm just letting gravity do some unwinding again. I'm going to trace my triceratops lines. to imagine I have a big triceratops. Ridges. And then pushing up from those feet again. Leading with the fingers this time. And coming back into that counter stretch. And releasing all that. Shake that out. Shake all that out. Hey, Susan. Nice to see you. I'm going to step back with the left foot into a moderate lunge, pulling the hips onto the perpendicular, tipping the tailbone, pulling back hip forward, forward hip back, checking that front knee isn't crunching past the front toes. Just enjoying that. Slide that out a little bit further, still pushing into that back heel with the feet on the parallel line. Hey, Rich, good to see ya. And then I'm going to swing that back heel from the parallel line onto the perpendicular line, opening the hips, pulling this knee, whatever that thing is, that way, and this hip that way, exploring this side plane here. Adjusting that, still trying to keep that knee from crunching past that toe. Relaxing the shoulders. And I'm going to keep sliding that foot out on that perpendicular line. Coming down onto the diagonal and bringing the right arm down on the inside of that right leg. I'm using them against each other for torque and support, but try not to collapse in that side. And then bringing the left arm up. To gaze past those fingertips. Just enjoying that aeroplane pose for a breath or two. And then I'm going to bring this arm down onto that diagonal. Just enjoying that long diagonal sensation out the foot, through the leg, up the side of the body, out those fingertips. And I'm going to shift onto the toes of that back foot, bringing that into a deep lunge, bringing weight onto both hands on the inside of that front foot, and bringing that front foot back to meet the back foot, pressing through the palms, fingers are wide, pressing through the spine, tipping the tailbone toward the back of the head, and pressing into the heels. Let's tread those heels, bending the right, pressing into the left. Bending the left, pressing into the right, trying to relax the belly. Again, pressing into the left, pressing into the right, and pressing the heart toward the earth. Into both heels, tipping the tailbone toward the back of the head. And swing the body forward, lifting the chest and the eyes, keeping the legs together. Bringing the upper body forward. Try not to collapse in the shoulders. I thought this headband was going to keep my hair out of my eyes, but all it's done is change things up. Drop in the belly, getting a nice stretch through the front of the body. I could add some silly noises and a tongue stretch there. If you feel inclined, that's a good spot for it. And then I'm going to lift those hips, pushing back again through the palms, through the spine, tipping the tailbone toward the back of the head and pressing into those heels. I'm going to swing that left foot forward in between the hands. A nice deep lunge and then straightening that leg a little bit, coming through a forward fold, and then keeping weight on those hands. I'm going to slide that foot forward for a splits-ish stretch. I call it that. It's a controlled, I'm keeping my weight on my hands. Encourage you, remind you, listen to your own body and do what feels good in your body. Just exploring that stretch a little bit. I haven't been adding that. I'm slowly getting back to my routine, pulling that heel back, bending that front leg, and stepping forward with the back leg. Hanging here in a forward fold again, just letting go of the belly, letting go of the back. Nice deep breath and a sigh. I'm going to roll up one vertebrae at a time, pushing again from the heels, from the earth really, through the heels, dipping the tailbone, coming up the spine, just checking in with the spine. Give that a little arm swing, a little letting things go. And I'm going to step back with this right foot into a moderate lunge on the other side, pulling that back hip forward, forward hip back, tucking the tailbone under a little bit, looking for a nice long and strong line through the core, checking that that front knee is not crunching past the front toes, pushing into that back heel. Feet are on more or less the parallel line, and hips are more or less on a perpendicular line. I'm just enjoying that upright, nice strong pose. Sliding that heel out a little bit more to a little bit deeper, still pulling those hips onto the perpendicular line. And then I'm going to swing that heel onto the perpendicular line. I think I said perpendicular instead of parallel last time. One of those P words, swinging the knee this way and this hip this way and exploring this side plane here, sliding that foot out a little bit more. See if I'm still sort of in frame. I got all kinds of things in my own way over there. That's one of my superpowers, putting things in my own way. I don't know about you, but I'm pretty good at it. I'm gonna come into a side triangle aeroplane pose on that side, bringing my left arm on the inside of my left leg for torque and support, and then lifting that right arm to gaze past those fingertips. And then bringing that hand down onto the diagonal, just enjoying that diagonal line. Energetic line out that heel through the side of the body, out the fingertips. And then I'm going to shift onto the back toe, rolling onto the toe and bringing both hands down on the inside of that left foot, bringing weight onto those hands and bringing the front foot back to meet the back foot, pressing through the palms, tucking the tailbone toward the back of the head, pressing the heart toward the earth and pressing into those heels. Fingers are wide, hopefully hands are not slipping. I'm going to come into plank position and do one slow push-up. I'm going to slide back a little bit, keeping the elbows in close to the body, keeping the legs in close to each other. Coming down nice and slow. I like to count to three and then hold for three at the bottom. And then pushing back up. Lifting the hips, pushing into the heels, tipping the tailbone toward the back of the head. And I'm going to swing that right foot forward in between the hands for a nice deep lunge on that side. And then stepping forward with that back foot. Oh, no, wait. Almost forgot. Straightening that front leg. Enjoying a forward fold over that right leg, and then sliding that heel out into a splits-ish position. Enjoying that stretch. I like to kind of rock that back and forth. Explore that range of motion. I haven't been doing that, so it's mighty stiff. It's good to be getting back to it. Remind you, you listen to your own body, and while pushing it a little bit is good, pushing it too much can have a rebound effect. So do be loving and mindful. I'm going to pull that heel back, bringing weight onto the front foot and then stepping forward with the back foot. Back into a forward fold and hanging here. Relaxing the belly. Oh no, mosquito. I'm going to bend the knees, swing the arms back. Coming into a counter stretch. Lifting the eyes and the chest. And then coming back to center. Shaking all that out. I must get to my paper crate before it gets too... settle into the bucket. I hope you're enjoying whatever you're into today and remembering to give yourself a little more love. Love yourself a little more. Because you're worth it. Susan Rich, it's great to see you. I wish you a fantastic day. Till next time, ciao.